Okay, hello cloud gurus, how y'all doing? Scott Fletcher here with another round of AWS news goodness. This week, Redshift gets some tasty new features, CloudWatch proves sharing is caring, and your CloudFront distribution might now be 24% better. Plus, we reveal the guru of the week right here on AWS This Week. Good news, everybody. CloudFront now supports Brotli. I, for one, am happy to see our favorite CDN step up for some green goodness. I mean, Brotli is way better than that kale stuff. Am I right? I'm being told that CloudFront now supports Brotli and not broccoli. Brotli is a lossless compression method for web traffic and performs better than good old gzip. Previously, you had to use a whitelist workaround to get CloudFront to play nice with Brotli, but that is no more as CloudFront now handles Brotli compression at the edge, delivering up to 24% smaller files. So what does this mean to you? Well, with smaller compressed web files, your web users will get faster load times while you could be saving up to 24% on your egress charges. Still not a kale fan. As legend has it, Redshift got its name as a not so subtle dig at Oracle. When Redshift was introduced, it provided a great pay-as-you-go alternative to the much more expensive on-prem data warehouse products at the time. This week, AWS announced some new features for Redshift in the way of a new data API and enhancements to spatial data handling. The new data API allows developers to sidestep the ODBC or JDBC connections and interact directly with the database using IAM or Secrets Manager for credentials. Additionally, AWS also upgraded the number of tables allowed in a single cluster from the already insane 20,000 tables to an even more insane 100,000 tables, which I can only imagine rooted in a specific customer request. Again, illustrating AWS's focus on the customer. You can now share your CloudWatch dashboard love with others, even publicly if you want to. This week, AWS announced that it's now possible to share CloudWatch dashboards without the need to provide console accounts. You now have three additional options. You can define specific email and passwords for access. You can use a third-party SSO provider, or you can make dashboards completely public. Many organizations like to publish their statistics or system performance publicly for transparency reasons, and now it is substantially easier with this new feature. And now on to the guru of the week. This week's winner is Ricard Legendi, a delivery manager from EPAM Systems in Budapest, Hungary, and also a published PhD. I especially appreciated your paper on agent-based dynamic network models. Well done, good sir. A lovely swag pack is headed your way. If you too would like to take a go at this week's Guru of the Week challenge question, head on down to the resource links for this video. And that, my friends, is all the AWS news that's fit to print this week. Stay safe, take care of one another's, eat your vegetables, and keep being awesome, cloud gurus.